This talk presents some of the evidence used to indicate that the U.S. Rocky Mountains form a broad, high plateau that mostly formed by 50 million years ago, but continues to uplift to this day. The Rocky Mountains are high. In this space shuttle image, we're looking towards the northwest from high above New Mexico. Yellowstone is in the far distance. Snow is covering the high peaks above 10,000 feet, or about 3 kilometers above sea level. But it isn't just the mountains that are at high elevation, even the basins are unusually elevated as well. For example, you are standing in the Laramie Basin at an elevation of 7,200 feet or 2,200 meters above sea level. So taken as a whole, the Rocky Mountains represent a large, high plateau along the backbone of the continent. Here we see an elevation map of the Rocky Mountain region. Low areas are in shades of green and high areas in brown and white. Major rivers are in blue. In red, we outline the Rocky Mountain Plateau, whose average elevation is 6,900 feet or 2,100 meters above sea level. The question is, when did this area reach this high elevation, and is it still rising today? Here we can outline the geologic history of the Rocky Mountains in the greater Wyoming area. We are concerned here with the Cenozoic era, which covers the past 65 million years. This is the time since the extinction of the dinosaurs. The Cenozoic era is composed of a series of geologic epochs shown here in green. Within the Cenozoic, we can summarize the major geologic events that affected Wyoming, including times of major faulting, periods of significant volcanism, and times of major deposition and erosion of the basins. Starting about 75 million years ago and continuing into the Cenozoic era, a period of major faulting took place to form the mountains of the Rockies. These faults are called thrust faults, and they result from major contraction or shortening of the continent. This event is called the Laramide Orogeny. The term orogeny refers to a period of mountain building. The event lasted 30 million years until about 45 million years ago. After this event, there was no major episode of faulting across the state for about 20 million years. But starting between 20 and 10 million years ago, normal faults developed, which resulted in continental extension or stretching. These faults moved intermittently through late Cenozoic time and continue to move today. During the Cenozoic era, there were two main periods of volcanic eruptions in the state. In early Cenozoic time, there were volcanic eruptions, principally in the Absaroka Mountains in the northwest part of the state, seen here. During the past few million years, volcanic eruptions again took place, primarily in the Yellowstone area, which is the source of its distinctive yellow rock. The basins of Wyoming have received sediment intermittently throughout most of the Cenozoic era. The units have a variety of formation names. But beginning about 6 to 8 million years ago, things changed, and these basins began to be eroded out. Today, they are still being incised into and evacuated by rivers. Taken together, these events record four main periods of geologic activity over the past 65 million years. Starting about 75 million years ago to about 45 million years ago, there was faulting and uplift of major mountain ranges during the Laramide orogeny. This was followed by a relatively calm period when faulting and then volcanism ended, but the basins continued to receive sediment from the surrounding eroding mountains. Beginning between 20 and 10 million years ago, normal faults began to form, which record modest stretching of the continent in this area. Then, starting around 8 to 6 million years ago, the basin began to be eroded into by rivers. We interpret this erosion to primarily record regional uplift of this part of the continent. However, in the past 2 to 4 million years, the Earth's climate changed and we entered into an ice age, which accelerated the rate of erosion. This history can be shown here in a simplified cross-section through the state from west to east. From about 75 to 45 million years ago, this part of the continent was squeezed and shortened by plate tectonic forces, resulting in thrust faults that brought up most of the mountain ranges in the state in a mountain building event called the Laramide orogeny. Sedimentary rocks, shown in red, were deposited in the basins between the mountain ranges. Here we can see one of these Laramide faults at Rattlesnake Mountain, west of Cody, Wyoming, in the northwest part of the state. The fault here is very steep, and rocks on the right side were moved upward along the fault as the region shortened under compression. During mountain building, the region began to subside and continued to subside following the end of the Laramide orogeny. During subsidence, sediment, shown in yellow, continued to fill the basins. In late Cenozoic time, the region began to move upwards due to processes active in the Earth's mantle beneath North America. As the area began to uplift, rivers were able to cut down into and erode the basin deposits. Climate change, as Earth entered the ice ages by 2 million years ago, swelled the rivers with water, accelerating erosion. The evidence for this history include two types of features seen in the landscape. Bedrock cut terraces are places where rivers have cut flat erosion surfaces into the old rocks of the mountain ranges. Such flat surfaces are found scattered across the Rocky Mountains and are shown in blue on this space shuttle image. A striking example is seen at the northern end of the Wind River Range in western Wyoming. Here, very old rocks have been beveled flat, suggesting at one time there was a continuous level erosion surface across the area. The second type of features seen in the Rockies are remnants of sedimentary rocks that once filled the basins. These remnant basin fill deposits, as well as the bedrock cut surfaces, are found up to a consistent level shown by the dashed line. As such, these features indicate that there has been up to about 3,000 feet, or nearly 1 kilometer, of incision into the Rockies over the past few million years. Here is an example of one of these basin fill deposits at Chalk Mountain near Casper, Wyoming. The white rocks are Cenozoic basin filling sedimentary rocks, and the flat surface at the top is the maximum height of the basin fill. Here is a view looking southwest from the top of Tatman Mountains in the middle of the Bighorn Basin towards the Absaroka Range. Here you can see the old river gravel sitting on the flat erosion surface at your feet, as well as the erosional remnants in the basin beyond that stand as a testament to the recent erosion history of the Wyoming landscape.